Hi guys, this is Jason here from Nathaniel, and in this lesson, we are going to learn how you can embellish a simple major or a minor chord in your left hand, right? Most of the techniques we look at for chord playing end up being in the right hand for, even intermediate players. But I think you need to work on how you can make your left hand sort of work in an autopilot mode so that the right hand can just take over the fancy stuff like melodies and embellishments and improvisation and so on and so forth. So in the left hand, the technique which I've developed works around something you have probably already done at some point before as a piano player if you've played melody and harmony before. What we generally do in the left hand will be an accompaniment using the root, the fifth, and the octave of a respective chord. In this case, the G major chord is played like this. G, D, G. Now, why we tend to choose fifth harmony in the bass is primarily because triads don't really work. Sounds very muddy and starts colliding with what the other musicians in our ensemble do. Also, it messes with the production if we are trying to do a bunch of tracks in a recording software. So what we tend to do in the left hand will be this sort of clean root, fifth, octave harmony. And this will work really well over any piece of music. If I'm playing a song using the G major chord and the C major chord, you can go something like this. D as well. This sounds quite interesting. The only problem is we are losing out the harmonic color, because in theory the fifth interval, which is D with respect to G, and the octave, which is the same G, doesn't really add an emotion, and that's what chords are all about at the end of the day. Chords are there to add that flavor and to add the color and to tell stories. And that's what's not happening right now on the left, because you're playing an interval which is a very vanilla or a plain interval, and stacking it with another obviously plain interval, the octave. So it sounds functionally good because you're playing the roots of the chords, but it doesn't work harmonically with respect to the color aspect. So what we then need to do, or the technique which I have developed for this lesson, will be to just focus on what your thumb is doing. Now the thumb, in my opinion, can float around because it doesn't have to always adhere to the G. Because you're already playing the G here, or the tonic, or the root of the chord. So why not try out a few other notes? In this case, you have the ninth, which is A, or the second played one octave higher. You have the tenth, which is a beautiful sound that's already giving you a G major chord, isn't it? Played up top, so it doesn't sound very muddy. I love that. That's the major seventh, F sharp. That's the major 6th E. And all these notes are diatonic within the G major realm, isn't it? It's all part of the scale, so why would it not sound good? So you have the default vanilla chord, if you will. That's your octave. You have the 9th, which is A. You can feel that color, right? You can feel that warmth of the major sound. The colorness of the 9th. The vanilla-ness of the octave, more color and little bit of tension with the seventh, and you have a very grand and epic kind of sound with the major six. So everything gives you a different flavor because they are different intervals. So what if you could develop a pattern around all of these intervals while the rest of your band, let's say the guitar player, is just holding a normal G major chord? They don't need to change their role. The vocalist doesn't need to change the melody. So let's see what you can do. And also, this technique is intending to put a stamp on your chord rhythm or your chord pattern. The listeners who hear our song will kind of remember the song not only for the lyrics or the vocal line, also the way you're playing your chord. For example, very inspired by that Police song, right? Every Breath You Take, right? You immediately know when the guitarist is playing it like that, wow, it's that song happening. So that's the intention. So you could build a pattern starting from the fifth chord. Of course, now I'm copying every breath you take, but you can also make it very, very unique. There we go. One and two and three and four and. So what did I do there? One and two and three and four and. Okay. Also inspire a vocal melody. What did I do there? That's B major third. Do do do. Ga re sa 3-2-1. So how do I do that with a nice arpeggio vibe? Of course. So it's a great way to kind of dynamically play a G major chord. Even though time is moving, if you play a G major like this, A, there's no color because you don't have the third. But if you play with the third, yes, there is a lot of color. We can make it even more dynamic by perhaps playing. So maybe you could try out this pattern, which I've developed now. Like I said, it can really inspire your vocal melody. Change the chord. So it's just a great way to kind of add some very unique elements to what you're doing in a song that you're working on or composing or doing a cover of, right? And again, this really frees up your right hand to just sort of stick with the melody line. So if I just keep something really simple going on in the right hand, you know, like just a single G. Also, like, if you know your octave playing in your right hand, you could just exclusively take your right hand to play octaves throughout, you know, 100%, because your left hand is doing so many things. It's holding the chords, it's handling the rhythm, it's also handling the color, you know. So there's so much the left hand is able to do now, and if you can work on templating the left hand, if you will, you can use this for so many songs which you compose. And you can also pretty much play a ton of melodies and a lot of your compositions probably with these templated left-hand patterns. Generally, when you learn left-hand patterns, you'd want to bank them. You'd want to program them into your subconscious mind so that you can use them for pretty much any piece of music barring spanning a lot of genres, right? So I hope you guys have found this lesson useful. Again, this is Jason here from Nathaniel. Don't forget to like the video, subscribe to our channel, turn on that bell icon for regular notifications whenever we release a new lesson. It'll be great to hear from you as well. So cheers and catch you in the next one.